Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update is all about the glacial flood that just started from Europe's largest glacier, Vatnajökull. There are in total 7 volcanic systems under the glacier, and what we are witnessing now is actually quite common. We have 2 ice cauldrons above a melting pot, geothermal area. We call them the Skaftá cauldrons because the water will flow down the river Skaftá, and it's a kind of general rule that every 2-3 years the meltwater level is high enough to lift up the ice cap, and millions of tons of meltwater take off to the sea. The Icelandic name for this is a jökulhlaup, and scientists think that this is the smaller cauldron that is causing the floods now. The last flood from there occurred in September 2021, but the larger ice cauldron, it could take off as well, although it is quite rare to see both of them discharge simultaneously. So if it's only going to be the small one this time, the floodwater will pose no threat to the highway, but we will however see it spread over the lava field and the river Skaftá. It flows through the village Kirkjubæjarklaustur and from there straight south all the way to the coast. But if the second cauldron would discharge as well now, we might get some troubles. Huge amount of floodwater. It could shut down highway number 1 for 1 or 2 days. But there is however a usable secondary route there. So right now we are not expecting any serious problems for tourists. But the civil defense has however issued a level of uncertainty, or until we know how this develops, and it is not a good idea to stay around near the river Skaftá, at least not today, since there is noticeable spike in electrical conductivity, and some gas pollution is always something that follows events like this. And the spikes in electrical conductivity can be quite normal. They might be caused by steam explosions from the geothermal area beneath the ice due to decreased water pressure resulting from the drainage of the cauldron. And I will leave links to news sources and the Met Office where you can see the water discharge in real time. But if you are by the south coast, it's a good idea to check the news every now and then, especially if you are going to drive between the villages Kirkjubæjarklaustur and Vík, where this is taking place. And we might see increased seismic activity under a glacier very soon. There is always the risk that this event could trigger something else, since the volcano Grímsvötn under the glacier Vatnajökull is very much ready to erupt. And overdue, in fact. So when millions of tons of floodwater discharge from the neighborhood, it can trigger something, like we know from history, although I do think it's unlikely. But this is, however, why a level of uncertainty was declared in case of some chain reaction. But since this looks as a flood from the smaller cauldron only right now, it is hardly worth the trip to go there filming. But if the meltwater from the larger cauldron will take off as well, I might have to think twice, because I do need proper flood footage from this area to have in my film stock, and it is very painful to see such a chance just flow by. And I would feel way better if the larger cauldron would just put on a show later, or when I have more time to be driving by. I just drove the complete ring road, and this location would cost me another such trip. And my focus right now are the seismometers by Grindavik. I look at them every few hours, ready to take off from the north to the Reykjanes Peninsula to try to capture the beginning of the next eruption. And since Iceland is getting so much international attention now, I felt it as a right to make it clear that this is nothing drastic happening by the glacier. It's still just a small event, but like I said, this could develop into some chain reaction, and the travelers should be aware of that. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.